Nice. So let's continue from where and the last thing we were on was stay with me one sec. So the last thing that we spoke about was the types of families, nuclear, extended, etc. So we saw as well where we have the lack of the paternal image as one of the issues coming forward. It is something that we see in Trinidad and Tobago, but also within the context of Latin American countries. And as I said, in everything that we do, the Cape Spanish exam, we are always putting it into the context of Spanish-speaking countries, especially Latin America, which is our region. So one of the common features, just as we see within the English-speaking or Anglophone Caribbean, by the way, the adjective for English-speaking is Anglophone, and we see that in Spanish, Anglo-parlante, which is English speaking. If you want to say Spanish speaking, Hispano parlante. Spanish speaking. If you want to say French speaking, that's Franco parlante. Yeah. Just a quick note before we go to the actual thing. So, you notice the same suffix, parlante, and Anglo meaning English, Hispano meaning Spanish, and Franco meaning French. Anglo parlante. Hispano parlante, Franco parlante, A-N-G-L-O parlante. Entonces, regresando al tema de las características de la familia hoy en día, we have falta de imagen paterna, lack of the paternal image, and this is because of all we see as hay un aumento de familias. Un aumento de familias. Monoparentales. Con la madre soltera. The single mom. A causa de divorcio, because of divorce, el divorcio, or maybe in some cases, a causa de la separación, separation of the parents, or in some cases, la muerte, the dad may have died early. And finally, in some cases, por evadir la responsabilidad. paterna. So many instances and reasons why we have this main characteristic of the father missing from the home. Well, we see an increase, hay un aumento de familias monoparentales, single mother homes. Y las razones por las cuales tenemos ese fenómeno, this phenomenon, es por la separación de los padres, el que la relación no salió bien, relation didn't work out, it didn't end well. Por el divorcio, pues la separación y el divorcio son igual. La única diferencia es que con el divorcio, los padres fueron casados. So the only difference is that with divorce, parents were actually married. Separation, they don't actually have to be married. They can stay married and divorce, or they may have never been married and they may have separated. También otra razón, another reason, es por la muerte, as well through death. Y finalmente, hay casos en donde el padre simplemente no asume su responsabilidad. So some instances, the father just doesn't assume his responsibility or evade su responsabilidad, evades his responsibility. Another main characteristic of the family in Latin America nowadays is la ausencia de la madre en el hogar. Ausencia de madre. Otro factor o característica de la familia hoy en día. Y vamos a ver que eso pasa, we will say that this happens because of la mujer trabaja, tiene horario como el padre, she has a schedule. Just like the father, which is outside of the home, fuera del hogar. What else? No está presente. Durante la infancia. No está tan presente. She isn't so present during infancy because she has to work. Entonces, ¿quién cuida a los hijos? Who takes care of the children? Una nodriza. So, una nodriza is a woman and a nanny. La guardería, which is the daycare, and another word we could use instead of nodriza is una niñera. O sea, ese puede ser una persona, pues una persona que no es parte de la familia, o puede ser un miembro de la familia, por ejemplo, la abuela. So this can be somebody that's not a member of the family at all, nanny. Especially in la guardería, especialmente en la guardería, especially in the daycare. Or it can be somebody that is part of the family, for instance, your grandmother, la abuela. Yeah? So just need to know that. But what we need to look at as well is what is the result of such a phenomenon occurring. Yeah? Este fenómeno, this phenomenon, de la madre ausente, o no tan involucrada como antes, or not as involved as before. This trend, we need to see what are some of the drawbacks of that. Yeah? Esa tendencia es una palabra femenina, tendencia, o ese fenómeno, este fenómeno. Tendencia o fenómeno, this trend or this phenomenon, which is the new or changing family in Latin America. What are some of the drawbacks of such a change? We need to ask ourselves this question. Yeah? Y los resultados, the results of this change include many things. One, La madre tiene más poder. So the woman has more power because she is, if she goes out to work now, which would have been different from any past, she actually goes out to work and stuff, and we see where this actually empowers her financially, economically. Yeah. So that's one thing. La madre tiene más poder, poder financiera, financiero, lo siento, financiero, financial, económico, económico. She has more financial or economic power. El padre, por otro lado, tiene menos poder. The father has less power y, o sea, e influencia. Since the father is absent, he doesn't yield as much influence as he had. He doesn't have as much power because he's not the only person that's providing financially. The woman is not ella no enfrenta una situación en que ella tiene que depender en su marido, en su hombre, para sustentar la familia financieramente. Ella no tiene que, ella no tiene que depender en él solo. So the woman is not in a position, as we have seen in the past, where she has to depend on this man to take care of her financial needs, take care of the family, and she cannot go anywhere. Because she now has this economic power, some of that power is removed from him. Because we'd have had a situation before where the woman would have depended on him. She no longer has to depend on him, but she has independencia. She now has independence. Another aspect is, and this is a huge one, and this is not Senor Weeks's perspective, but there's scientific proof to show this. There have been lots of studies from a sociological point of view, from a psychological point of view, social sciences, and there have been lots of studies to show what exactly is the impact of the absent father in the home. So let's look at some of those. La ausencia paterna causa problemas de ausencia paterna causa. What are some of the problems it causes? We have el rendimiento educacional, as one. So educational performance of children, leso prole. This is not a sweeping generalization to say every child that has an absent father is going to perform poorly in school. However, the vast majority of persons in this situation where there's the absent father, usually on many instances have issues with school performance. And as I said, these things have been scientifically proven as well. So, afectar al rendimiento educacional también afecta al el estado afectivo, the affective state. What does the word afectivo mean? Affective means dealing with the emotions, yeah? So it also, el estado, lo siento, it also affects the emotional state de niño, niña. Emotional state of the child, the boy or the girl. What it can also do is, it creates condiciones de aislamiento, isolation by kids. It also creates, and we see this more in boys, aggressividad, problemas de bajo autoestima, problems of low self-esteem as well. Good night, Kyle. So So all these are some of the issues that we see coming up. So let me leave 1 minute for this just to be taken now, and we continue. So what we're looking at here, just to recap, what are some of the results of these changes that we see in the family structure? Okay. I think I came on just about 8. I'm not sure what happened there, but no need to stress, it will be posted on the channel after, so you could always go back and look at it from it up. And I started off the lesson as well, going over some of the things that we would have ended off at. I'm not sure how much before into the feed or at what position exactly we'd have had those issues with the connection. So I made sure and went back and go over some of the things that we've done before. So no need to stress, guys. So what are some of the results, the drawbacks, the consequences of this change family structure in Latin America? And these are facts that we need to know, because Cape would always bring their essays, not the essays, the comprehension and stuff from this perspective with these things in mind. And we need to remember as well that many times we have to state our own position. So we need to be very much aware of the topic and very much aware of the issues surrounding the topic to be able to formulate an answer that is credible, meaning it is not our own personal opinion, but it has been researched and proven. It is also coherent. Our responses must also be coherent. Yeah? Not contradicting itself, one part of the response we see here and we see something totally different in another place. So what are the results, the drawback, las consecuencias de esa nueva familia de América Latina, this new Latin American family? La madre tiene más poder financiero y económico. The mom has more financial and economic power because she now works and has the same sort of schedule o horario como el padre. Also, el padre tiene menos poder e influencia. Whenever we have a word beginning with I, the letter I, and we have the word and, which in Spanish is E, coming before, we change that Y to an E. So, poder e influencia. I know it's possible that we may have known this before, but just for the sake of reiterating, I don't want to take anything for granted to say that we don't know that kind of thing. Or to take for granted that we know when something that may have been missed before. So, el padre tiene menos poder e influencia. Father now has less power and influence. One of the drivers of that power for the male before, for the father, the home before, would have been the fact that he was the economic anchor in the home, if you want to call it that. So he would have held on the home, he would have gone out and ganar la vida, earn a living, sustentar a la familia, sustain the family financieramente, financially, of course. But now that the mother does this as well, he doesn't have the same amount of power that he has because the situations have been changed. We also look at his influence, the fact that the father is less present or absent in some cases. He has less influence over the children. And most importantly, what does this absence lead to? Yeah, we are seeing where this absence leads to el rendimiento educacional de su prole, so the educational performance of his offspring. And as I stated before, this is not my personal opinion, but social science and social scientists, psychologists, sociologists have proven this over many years of study, decades. El estado afectivo del niño, the emotional state, affective is an adjective meaning emotional impact. So the emotional state of the child as well is affected. Y también, also, the absence of the father crea condiciones de aislamiento. It creates conditions of isolation, agresividad, aggression, y bajo autoestima, low self-esteem as well. Yeah? And that brings us to the end of the topic of the family structure, the changing family structure in Latin America. We move on now to interesting topic, young people and their values. So, los valores, de los jóvenes. Value of youth, or youth and their values. So I decided to do this in two parts, or by doing a table. We have the positive values of youth, and also the negative values of youth. Once again, these are scientific stuff that I've been researching and stuff. And in many instances, you may say, well, it's not me, I'm not like that. But this is a generalization. This is not on an individual and say, you, Mr. Medina, you are this way. Or you fall in this category, not particularly. But we're going to see what are some of the things that you value, where their value systems are. And we're looking at that both in a positive and negative sense. So first and foremost, we have La Amistad. La Amistad. This is big on the list. Friendship is big on the list for youth. Of one of the things that they value. So se manifiestan. Or manifestación. Como prioridad. So, friendship relationships are manifested as having some sort of priority in the life of youth. There's one. Also, anhelan, A-N-H-E-L-A-N, los jóvenes, youth. Anhelar, A-N-H-E-L-A-R, means to long for, to even for, to long for. Anhelan ser parte de su grupo. Very common thing with youth. Coconut coffee. Very common thing with youth is having friendships or relationships that they value and being part of a group. Yeah? Being part of a group, that's a very important thing to you, so a very important value. Also, we have el amor. And when we say el amor, this is, I'm going to use the black itself. When we say el amor, we're not talking about specifically romantic type of love. I'm going to just write it here, el amor, for the sake of space. But when you're talking about love, we're speaking about strong feelings of affection that they have between their group, whether it be for friends, not limited to but included romantic relationships, boyfriend, girlfriend, that sort of stuff. And knowing that somebody is willing to sacrifice for them. Excuse one second. Excuse me. So ese valor o ese sentimiento de amor tiene que ver con hacer sacrificio making a sacrifice para uno means like one as in someone. So these feelings of love, not only limited to romantic. So yes, we can include romantic love in them, but it also has to do with making a sacrifice for one, for somebody else, or somebody showing they are making that sacrifice for us as well. And not only making a sacrifice, y mostrar fidelidad. Showing as well some sort of fidelity, some sort of loyalty. Yeah? You don't want to think that the persons that we trust in and invest our time in, that they do not feel the same way about us, that they do not value us, that they would not defend us. So these are some of the things, the positive. We have one more positive to go. And then I'll go on to the negatives. So, amistad, friendship, being part of a group, that's important for you. Amor, love, or somebody showing sacrifice for you, as well as showing loyalty. And the third positive that we have is la solidaridad, solidarity. La solidaridad. And solidarity has to do with ser bien parte, un compromiso, a commitment, or que defiende una causa, defends a cause. And this cause could be a political cause, it could be an environmental cause, it could be a social cause, it could be a sporting cause, whatever it is. The youth like to feel part of a larger group than the family. A simple thing as loving FC Barcelona, that might be a youth way of showing solidarity. Love for the environment and hate for pollution, that sort of stuff. A lot youths are way more environmentally conscious nowadays than in times past. That's another way of showing solidarity. This whole aspect of the Black Power movement in the 1970s in Trinidad and Tobago, that was led by youth as well. So persons felt marginalized in society. They felt as if they were downtrodden and they didn't have opportunities. And they came together, believing that seeing their self-worth and seeing what was going on in the States as well, and they would have bought into that same sentiment that was going on in the States with the civil rights movement. And we had a Black Power revolution in Trinidad and Tobago as well. So, and the persons that would have spearheaded that, persons like McCandell Daga, these persons would have been youth, they would have been university students. Yeah? So they would have expressed their solidarity in that way. Now, one other thing I wanted to mention. Defiende una causa, depends on shared cause, compartida. So it's always shared, and as I said, it does not have to be a political cause. It does not. One second. Compañerismo, thank you. Yes, love Barcelona. Love for FCB. Mexican club, as they say. So, compañerismo ties into that as well. So what I would have done is pick out the most important ones. I know that Kofi will be aware of some of the other stuff. So thank you, Kofi, for that. That is one of the other things. And if you want to just give us, for the rest of the viewers that are there, just give us a quick thing on what exactly is compañerismo? What do you understand by compañerismo? I know that it ties into some of the other stuff that we looked at as well. But just shoot us a message in the chat there, Kofi, giving us a quick definition of what is or what you understand by companionism. Now let's look at the negative aspects or the negative values of youth. And when we say negative, both from the perspective of not only persons harboring or having these negative traits, but also these traits are frowned upon by youth. So we have NVIDIA, which is envy. And envidia tiene que ver con, has to do with desear de las virtudes o bienes ajenos. Desear de las virtudes o bienes ajenos. And once we see this adjective ajenos, that means referring to somebody else, so somebody else's own. And bienes means goods, virtudes means virtues. So you might see somebody that has, they are very affable, they seem to be the limelight, always the center of attention in a social group. Somebody not liking somebody else and not having a justifiable reason, when we dig a little bit deeper, realize the reason is because there may be some sort of envy or jealousy, celos, for that specific virtue that the person possesses. Or somebody else may have all the latest clothes. Once again, jealousy because of that, a physical thing, good. That is something that is frowned upon by youth. And it's something that we see possessed as well. Not only by you, even my person's older as well, person's younger. Yeah? And it doesn't have to do with this this envidia, no tiene que ver, but it doesn't have to do with possessing anything. Or it isn't limited to that, no tiene que ver con. And this phrase, tiene que ver con, means has to do with poseer la cosa o virtud, sino, but it has to do with una ansiedad. Hacia la cosa. So there's that strong feeling of wishing, not so much actually going the full distance to try and possess the thing. That is what we're talking about, and that is something that is wrong with one. Yeah? We also have el abuso, abuse. So I'm giving you some time to write down that while I just explain. We also have el abuso, abuse, and en la búsqueda de independencia, in the search for independence, it is very common for youth to abuse this freedom, libertad que posee, this freedom that it possesses. It's a very common thing. So what are some examples of youth coming into certain freedom and abusing it? Many different things. We have drug abuse, el drogadicto, or drug addict, yeah. Also abuso de sexo, abuse of sex. Before you used to live in your parents' home, talking plain, you used to live in your parents' home and things were restricted. You're now in a university in a foreign country. And that sort of supervision is not like it was there before. You have a girlfriend. Sometimes you're missing class because doing big people thing as it is. So you also have abuse of money. Learning how to deal with finances, learning how to spend wisely, how to save, how to be prudent with finances. This abuse of freedom in that regard is seen as well. Also abuse of time. That's a very common thing with youth, learning how to manage your time. That's another thing that is abused. In the process of learning that, time is abused many times. Yeah? We don't put aside or give the appropriate time for different things. We still have to learn time management. We still have to learn self-discipline, autodisciplina. Yeah? So let's look at abuse and some of those wonderful ones that are called out as well. We will look at those. So we have abuso, abuse, and in la búsqueda, in the search, de independencia, the search for independence is común, it is very common, que los jóvenes abusan su nueva libertad. They abuse their new freedom. And this abuse may come in the form of dinero, money. An abuse of money can come in the form of, say for instance, your parents give you a credit card and you are using this money to purchase things that you do not need. You want to go to the club every Friday and you have to pay for that. You have to pay for drinks in the club. Credit card being spent, but your parents would have given you that for emergency spending. So abuse of money, dinero, is seen in the form of deudas, debts. Deuda, la deuda is debt. Abuse of droga. And you know we have cocaína, marijuana, etc. Yeah, we have cocaine, we have Marijuana, we also have ale, alcohol. All is happening the way of searching and living in this newfound freedom. We also have abuse of sex. So, yeah, my God, I'm looking for the word. The word in English is, I can't remember the word in English, but it's a phrase in Spanish. No hay que confundir la libertad con el libertinaje. Don't confuse. Okay, Kofi, no problem. We'll look at another. But it's a phrase in Spanish. No hay que confundir la libertad con el libertinaje. So the abuse of sex is seen in, that word is el libertinaje. For the life of me, I cannot remember the word in English right now. My God. Libertinaje, libertinaje. Debauchery is the word. Thank you. That's the word, debauchery. Yes, celoso tiene que ver con o es muy relacionado con envidia. So thanks for that as well, Kofi. Jealousy is also tied in with envidia, the point of envy that we saw before. So el libertinaje es el abuso de sexo. Debauchery is the abuse of sex. The abuse of drugs, cocaína, marijuana, alcohol, the abuse of money, dinero, we have deudas, which is comment a lot of debt. We also have abuso de tiempo, the abuse of time, which is mal manejo, bad time management, de tiempo. And all of these are tied into, as well, most of these things in adult life, like I like to tell people, budgeting and this sort of stuff is basic mathematics. The issue with budgeting is not the mathematics part. Yeah, once you don't even have to pass the exam mathematics to be able to budget. But the issue with these things, with these financial things and many things in our adult life, is tied to auto disciplina, self-discipline. Once ever we see this prefix auto in Spanish, it usually means self. Autoestima, self-esteem. Autodisciplina, self-discipline. So all of these problems, abuse of freedom, abuse of money, drugs, sex, time, all these really actually have to do with la falta de autodisciplina, lack of self-discipline. Yeah, so make a note of that. I'm giving you 1 minute to take in everything, and then we move on to the last point in the values of youth. So we look at the positives and we also look at the negatives. So take 1 minute just to finish up that and take in everything. Nice, we good to go. So the last point, the last negative value of youth, and as I say, this is not an exhaustive list, but this is some of the main things, or the things that I deem important, not only from a perspective of what comes in CAP exams, but also from the perspective of the most spoken about ones as well. And the final VCO, if you want to call it vice, or negative value of youth is la apatía, apathy. And apathy is basically disinterest or lack of interest in Almost anything.
Yeah. So, no querer ser parte de un grupo. Not wanting to be part of a group. Poseer, possessing. El desinterés. Possessing disinterest. Also, el aislamiento.
Isolation, reclusing yourself. All these are parts of. And it's the same. Imagine trying to strike up a conversation with somebody. Meet somebody for the first time and you have to strike up a conversation with them. Enrolling in your university and the teacher and or your lecturer and your in your tutorial, the person says, look to the person on your right and you spend 5 minutes and telling that person about yourself. How boring, how annoying would it be to meet somebody that does not have any interest in anything, no common speaking points or anything like that. Yeah. So we could understand what it means to possess la apatía, to possess apathy. And how that is frowned upon amongst youth. So, we want to move immediately to the next topic, which is el deporte o los deportes. So far we have done, based on the syllabus, we have done, spoken about structure and function of the family. What role does the family play? What is the traditional structure? What is the current structure? And what are some of the drawbacks of these changes that we see nowadays? We look at young people and their values. We want to look at sports next. And finally, we look at health. Health and fitness, living a healthy lifestyle, and what are some of the main things coming out of that. So, los deportes. Un deporte es una actividad física que se realiza con objetivos de recreación o competencia. Yeah. So, what is sport? Sport is an activity. El deporte es una actividad que se realiza. No, realizar doesn't mean to realize, as in to come to understand or know something. However, it means to fulfill. So, el deporte es una actividad que se realiza con objetivos. De recreación, of recreation, o competencia, or even competition, and it is such that convertirse en profesional. So this we know already. Everybody knows about Lionel Messi, LeBron James, all these famous sports, Tom Brady. So this is a physical activity that they do. They may have started off for recreational purposes as a child, but they have dedicated themselves. Se dedicó hasta se convirtió en profesional. They dedicated themselves to the point where they became a professional in that thing. Yeah, and that is the benefit of sports. What does sport do, or what is a sport or physical activity? It's una actividad que saca el cuerpo. It takes the body de un estado de reposo. De un estado de reposo. Reposo means relaxation or calmness. So there's no sport, or I like to think there's no sport that we do that your body is in a normal relaxed state as you would be if you're lying on a couch at home and relaxing. Yeah. So some physical activity that takes us out of our, or takes the body out of a state of rest. Yeah? And what it helps as well is el cuerpo, the body, se mantiene en forma. So the body is kept in shape or en un buen nivel físico. The body is kept in shape or is kept in a good physical condition. To have the physical condition. So how are we so far? Everybody good? Everybody following? Is the information beneficial? Well, I'm letting you write down that. Send a comment. Let me know. Let me know if it is you're following with me. Everybody's good. We all on the same page. I don't want to lose you all in all the teaching. Okay. Nice. So I think that's enough time. Let's continue. So let's look at what does, in everything, remember the name of the module is the individual. I'm going to repeat it correctly from the syllabus. Individual, la familia y la vida diaria. So the individual, everything as best as possible, we'll try to look at from the perspective of its impact or importance to the individual, family, and daily life. So we saw with family how the individual is affected by the absence of the father, and we saw the family structures. But looking now at sport, and we are seeing how does it affect or what impact does it have on the individual? One second. Nice. We're going to look and see what impact is happening on the individual as well. So we got a rough definition of sport. What does it entail as well as stuff? Now let's look at what does it allow for the individual? What benefit does it have for the individual? So just letting you all know, next week we will be working on doing past paper questions together. Looking at entire papers. So for instance, we'll do the whole of a paper 2 on one day, whole of a paper 1 on another day, that sort of stuff, yeah? So looking forward to that and giving us guidance as we go along as best as possible. So I'll be sharing that stuff with you all. Most likely we'll do it on Zoom because I'd like to get the interaction with you all as well. So we may use a different platform next week, but I'll keep you all posted on that. Nice, so moving forward, what does sport do for the individual? El deporte permite al individuo, allows the individual, one, relajarse, the form of relaxation. So even though, yes, thank you, Kurt. So even though the body is put into a physical state, you are still relaxing because it's not an activity that causes stress, but that releases stress. So by that releasing of stress, there's only the relaxing aspect. Also, despreocuparse de la rutina, despreocuparse de la rutina. So to not worry or not be preoccupied of routine. Yeah, we're not stuck in Nice.
Hydrate is an example as always, not physical activity, but we look at that. We look at that just now as well, Kofi, when we're breaking down sports under different subcategories, whether it's group sports, individual, recreational, that sort of stuff. So relajarse, to relax, despreocuparse de la rutina, not to worry about the routine or take yourself out of the routine and just relax yourself. It also helps to liberar tension. Sport also does this, help us to release tension. And most importantly, divertirse, have fun. So these are the things that sport allows for the individual.
Wait, now, the man say, ajedrez and laugh. I thought you were being serious. I don't want to see the laughing emoji. No, but that can be included there. So, matter of fact, let me write it here one time. Different types of sports. We have deportes grupales. El deporte grupal, for instance. Football. Baloncesto. We also have individual sports, for instance, tennis, la natación, tennis and swimming. And what about recreational? You may have been joking, but chess could be considered recreativo. Recreativo. Other examples of recreational sports, you know, on ESPN, we'll see this. Here we also have dardos, D-A-R-D-O-S. It's darts, you know, that sport where they throw the darts after the bullseye. We have dardos, and we have billiards, or pool, as we like to say here. So not to confuse these with. Let me just draw a line so that we don't confuse. So we have different types of sports. We have group sport, football, basketball, individual sport, tennis, swimming. I know in tennis you may have doubles, as they call it, or group. And also we have recreational sports, darts and billiards, or pool. Nice. Mejoramiento de la salud. Excellent. Improvement of health. That's another benefit of sports. And we will also see that when we actually, that is the next thing we're going to talk about. So let me give 1 minute for this and we look into the benefits of sport. What are the specific benefits of sports that can be derived? We'll look at the benefits and the negative aspects as well. Nos brinda la oportunidad de socialización y facilita éxito en el ámbito escolar. Muy bien. So it gives us or affords us the opportunity of socialization and facilitates success in the scholarly ambit. Bright fellows there, who's the teacher? I coping, right? Huh? Knows the stuff. So beneficios del deporte, Kyle, worry, I haven't forgotten you either. I still have to look up online information. I'm not thinking I have to call the ministry in the morning. So benefits of sports. So you can head up any book, benefits of sports. I don't limited with space here. So let's look at it. I know about the glare here as well. So that's why I'm making sure I'm reading out everything so that we can hear me as well, even though some of the words might be lost there. So what are some of the benefits of sport? First and foremost, as was stated, mejora la salud. It improves health. How does it do that? It helps us to mantener la forma. It helps us to mantener la forma. What does it help as well? Nice. It helps us to stay in shape. But the point I wanted to make here with staying in shape and improved health is the other statistic I want to give you: 6% de enfermedades of sicknesses que lleva, that lead to a la muerte. Of illnesses that lead to death are owed to or se debe a la falta de actividad física. So 6% of illnesses that lead to death are caused by or are owed to the lack of physical activity. And what are some examples of these illnesses or deaths? We have la diabetes, type 2 diabetes, y las enfermedades cardiovasculares. So anybody that knows the word cardiovascular before, that the biology before, we know that means relating to the heart. So heart-related illnesses, type 2 diabetes in particular, are all caused by lack of physical activity. So taking part in some sort of sport gives us the benefit of improving our health and evading or evading these sicknesses. Mente sana en cuerpo sano. Mente sana, sorry, a sound mind in cuerpo sano. A sound mind and a sound body, that's what that means. If I'm not mistaken, we know the brand Asics. I know most of us will know the Nike and the Adidas, but there's also a brand of shoe called Asics. Yeah, I believe that their acronym ASICS, E6, actually stands for the Latin version of the same thing. A healthy mind and a healthy body, yeah? That's a little fun fact there. So, taking part in sports gives us una mente sana en cuerpo sano, gives us a sound mind and a sound body, por, by, mejorando nuestro estado de ánimo. It mejora, it improves nuestro, our estado de ánimo, our state of well-being, or yeah, animals like well-being or feeling good, basically good spirits. Reduce niveles de estrés. So reduce, for the sake of space, I wouldn't put niveles, levels of, reduce estrés, stress, ansiedad, anxiety, y depresión. So we've seen here the mental benefits towards sport. So we have the physical benefits of giving us a body that is able to withstand certain pressures and not fall into certain common illnesses that are caused by lack of physical activity. And we also have the mental benefits as well.
And how do these things happen? The mental benefits for liberación de endorphins. So whenever we take part in sports, we have endorphins that are released, liberación de endorphins. And when endorphins are released, for the persons that are doing PE, they may notice as well, nos hace, it makes us sentir, feel feliz. It makes us feel happy. Or the feel-good hormones, as they call it, yeah? So, benefits, one, improves our health, two, improves our mind, or gives us a healthy mind. Mente sana, healthy mind, and cuerpo sana, on a healthy body. Because the body is improved, and the mind consequently is improved. Our state of well-being is increased. Stress, anxiety, depression decreased, and feel-good hormones are released. What about, what else about sports? Point number three. Sports gives us the opportunity to socialize in a clean and a healthy way. Nos hace socializar. It helps us to socialize. Sanamente, sanamente. Healthily. Yeah, so as we saw with youth before, their values, we have a sense of solidaridad entre un grupo, a sense of solidarity or belonging within a group, and that helps us to socialize well. Also, tomar parte de deporte, tomar parte en deporte nos hace, it makes us no caer o usar tiempo improductivo. Let me get very correct in that appropriate way, right? Nos hace no pasar tiempo. No pasar tiempo improductivo. So it helps us to not spend idle time. Coming from this point, no caemos en vicios. We don't fall into vices such as Kofi, what are you talking about, babe? You're talking about train of thought there, right? It helps us to not fall into certain vices such as drug use, etc. No caemos en vicios. We do not fall into vices such as smoking drugs. Now, of course, this is in a general sense. Once we have that consciousness, ese conocimiento de la vida sana, we have this consciousness of a healthy life, que logramos por el deporte, that we are able to achieve through sports, it will give us a better chance of not doing these things. That is not to say that somebody will play football and somebody wouldn't be a footballer and a smoker at the same time. These things do exist, but it gives us this consciousness, this conocimiento. Point number four, as I say, this is a review. Facilita el éxito académico. So many studies have shown as well. Facilita el éxito. It facilitates académico. Academic success. How? There are studies that suggest that success in sport leads to academic success. Éxito en deporte conduce
say conduce a means lead to éxito académico, academic success. Yeah, what is created when we in sports or when we take part in sports? Un espíritu, a spirit of excelencia de competir. Many times we like to, you know, most things have both a positive and a negative connotation. So many times nowadays we like to think of competing as something negative, but it's not necessarily so. So that spirit of competitiveness, competitividad, or espiritual competir, the spirit of competing and spirit of excellence that we develop through sports, we carry it, nos lleva al ámbito también académico. We also carry it to the academic ambit or academic esfera. Yeah? And that creates the success in our schoolwork as well. Point number 5, una herramienta para desarrollar el carácter. So sport is a good tool, una herramienta para desarrollar, to develop el carácter. How? Sport is a tool, herramienta para desarrollar, to develop el carácter. How does sport develop character in persons? Fomenta valores y nos ayuda a forjar. Fomenta. What does fomenta mean? Fomenta comes from the word fomentar, which means desarrollar. So this is a synonym for develop. Fomenta valores, values, y nos ayuda a forjar el carácter. Helps us to forge or shape character. What exactly is character? Character is those traits that we develop by going through certain stresses in life. Why is it stresses? I don't mean this in a negative sense. But a simple thing, let's give an example. I do not have, my washing machine stops working. I am forced to have to learn how to wash by hand. Characters developed by that. Yeah, that's one way of developing characters. So you do not depend on one thing, but you look for innovative or alternative solutions to solve the problem that you have at hand. That sort of stuff is character development. And sports develop that as well, develop certain values as well. So the value that can be developed in that same example is a trait or the value of what we like to call, well, I'm going to say stick-to-itness or perseverance. I'm going to solve this problem, and I'm going to use creative means, I'm going to use alternative means outside of my comfort zone or outside of what I already know. That's character development. Sport also encourages teamwork. Alentar is good to encourage. Y el deporte alienta, especially in team sports. The radical changing group alienta el trabajo en equipo. It develops teamwork, you know, the ability to work in teams. It teaches us a very important lesson. Cómo ganar y perder. How to win and to lose de manera humilde, with humility. Y what's the other thing I'm going to say? Y orgullo. So you learn, you lose and you win and you maintain your pride. Mantenemos nuestro orgullo. We maintain our pride, pero somos humildes también. Yeah, we are humble as well. What does a sport do?
Fomenta. You see the word fomenta again. El auto estima. It develops self-esteem. Remember we made this word before?
Auto meaning self. It develops self-esteem. What exactly is self-esteem? Self-esteem is not somebody telling us, hey, you know, you are a wonderful person. Hey, you know, you are excellent. Self-esteem is we putting ourselves through a specific task and recognizing that we have become successful, or recognizing that we are good at the thing, and the good feeling that comes over us by knowing that I am useful, I can do something, I can be successful at something. That is self-esteem. The high esteem or the high rank that we place on our own selves in our mind. Yeah? Not to be mistaken with pride, of course. So it develops or encourages self-esteem. It also teaches us to manage stress under tension. El manejo. De estrés. Bajo la tensión. Many persons cannot work under pressure, but sport teaches us to do this. We learn you have to take that penalty kick for the final in front of a stadium. The whole school is there, the other school is there. The school that you're playing against behind the goal and cheering your hand saying you're going to miss. Your school is far. And you're not hearing any support, and you have to step up to take a penalty kick in a football match finals. Yeah? And you have to compose yourself and manage the stress under that pressure to score the goal. Sport teaches us that. We would not have been in a situation where we could have developed that management of stress if it is we were not taking part in sport. And finally, I'm going to drop off. Sorry, I pressed something by error. Finally, sport also teaches us, or also develops in us, leadership abilities. It contributes contribuye al desarrollo. It contributes to development de habilidades de liderazgo. So liderazgo is something leadership. It contributes to the development of leadership capabilities or abilities. Almost there, guys. I'm going straight through. Less smalls, right, Kofi? Less smalls. And I'm going straight through. So we have this. These are the positive aspects. Who would have thought that we could have negative aspects of sport as well? We do have negative aspects of sport. We're going to take a look at them within the next minute. Finish right on that. Let me grab a drink of water and then let me come back. We're going to look at the negative aspects of sports, and we're going to go straight into what a healthy lifestyle entails. Just on the finish line. Okay. Nice. Negative aspects of sport now.
way less, but we need to know them still.
Way less than the positives, sorry, but we need to know them. One is el gamberismo.
El gamberismo.
Excuse me, and what is el gamberismo? What we like to call hooliganism. So we have, you know, a lot of my references will be football, as you realize. I don't watch it as much, but that's one of my first loves, I like to say, football. So a lot of football references. So Manchester United is playing Manchester City. And Manchester United loses. Now, some persons would have paid and they reached into the stadium and they were allowed to get a ticket. So it's all well and good. They got into the stadium and they got a ticket. They watched the match there. Some persons watch the match from a pub or a bar close by outside the stadium. When Manchester United loses, they say, we are not going to take that. We are going to mash up this pub. We are going to mash up the streets. And that sort of behavior, that negative behavior that is created because of this strong sense of belonging or this strong love and affection for the club, and when it is there in bad times, you cannot stand it. This strong sense is what we call hooliganism. We could have said hooligan, as we say in English, H-O-O-L-I-G-A-N, hooligan, and then add ismo, the N, hooliganismo. That's the word in Spanish, or we could also say el gamberismo. But the reason why I chose this one is because I'm sure that if we see hooliganismo or hear it, maybe we'll know all hooliganism they're talking about, and we'll have an idea. So we need to know, as I mentioned yesterday, the synonyms. So el gamberismo or el hooliganismo es un fuerte afán para un grupo o un equipo deportivo hasta el punto de comportarse sin pensar en otras y hasta destruir la o ser violento a los demás y su propiedad. That's the writing now. El gamberismo, hooliganism, es un fuerte afán, A-F-A-N, para un grupo o equipo deportivo, a sporting group or team, hasta el punto de all to the point of doing what? Comportarse con violencia, behaving with violence, or ser violento, being violent, y sin pensar, without thinking, en otros, other persons. It could also be, what could also be included in that is ser bien destructivo con la propiedad de otros, of other persons. So let's get that. And the other point we're going to look at is doping. While sports help us to manage stress, not everyone is able to manage that stress. Some people fold under that stress. Some people crumble under that stress. And that stress causes them to use drugs, performance-enhancing drugs. That sort of stuff. So finish taking on that and we move on to that point. Performance. Nice, you're moving along. We're moving along now to El Dopaje. El Dopaje is what we call doping. Doping in sports is a serious issue. Anybody that is into Olympics as well, they will have noticed that and seen that it's a very serious issue. El Dopaje. Doping. Las ganas de tener éxito y no fracasar. What is las ganas? Las ganas is the desire. Las ganas o el deseo, podemos decir, can also say deseo. Las ganas de tener éxito y no fallar. Fallar means to fail. Fracasar also means to fail. And un fallo o un fracaso would mean a failure. Las ganas de tener éxito, the desire to be successful and not fail, leads one, lleva a uno, a uno to use, usar drogas, to use drugs, que aumenta el rendimiento. Drugs that improves or increases performance. And this is how we can say performance enhances drugs. Yeah? Hay personas que... So the desire or the will, la voluntad de tener éxito y no fracasar o fallar, the desire, the will to be successful and not fail, lleva a uno, leads one to use drugs that increase performance. And could also say desmoronarse bajo la presión de rendir. Se desmoronarse means to fall or to crumble. Uno puede, one can, desmoronarse. Am I being dyslexic right now? No, I'm correct. Desmoronarse bajo la presión. To fall under pressure. Or the pressure to perform, la presión de rendir. Rendir by itself means to perform. When we make it reflexive, rendirse, it can mean to give up. So if we tell somebody, no se rinde en el campo de deporte, we tell somebody in the football field, no se rinde, don't give up. But rendir by itself means to perform. Rendirse means to give up. Rendir by itself means to perform. You got that, yeah? I'm just reading some news here. I'm not giving out any information as yet, as nothing is confirmed. Looking at possibly a change in exam dates, possibly. Again, possibly, nothing confirmed as yet. Right, so we finished with that. I want to finish early tonight as possible, as early tonight as possible. Let's go straight into the last topic, which is a healthy life, what constitutes or makes up a healthy life and a healthy lifestyle. Now let's get straight into that. So that is la vida
Sana, S-A-N-A, sorry.
A healthy lifestyle. What is a healthy lifestyle? So even before we look at that, we want to look at what is life or what constitutes life. What constitutes life? No, I'm not trying to answer an age-old question, but just in a general sense. La vida is, what is la vida? La vida is, instead of writing it over, I'll put it like this. La vida is nacer, to be born, desarrollarse,
to develop, or in other words, we can say crecer, to grow,
to develop or to grow, reproducirse,
to reproduce,
y finally, we could say morir, M-O-R-I-R, or a more upscale version of morir, or a form 6 advanced way of saying to die is fallecer. So this is what constitutes life, being born, growing and developing, reproducing or making offspring and eventually dying. Now let us look at the stages of life. Las etapas de la vida. What are the stages of life? We have birth, nacimiento, and these are good phrases that we need to know,
especially when we're meeting it in, to use for our own purposes, and also when we're meeting it in passages and stuff. So we have the stages of life will be el nacimiento, the only one that is masculine and gender, el nacimiento. After birth, we have la infancia, infancy. After infancy, we have what is considered childhood, la niñez. After childhood, we have adolescence, la adolescencia. Adolescence. After adolescence, we have adulthood or adult life, la adultez. And finally, la vejez. Another way of saying la vejez, you may also hear la tercera edad. The third age, literally, la tercera edad or la vejez, which means old age. Yeah, so these are the stages of life. This is what life entails, being born, developing, growing, reproducing, or making offspring, prole, offspring. And fallecer, die. So if these are the things that constitute life, life in general, because we're looking at both aspects of the phrase. The first aspect of the phrase is life. This is what constitutes life. What constitutes a healthy life? That's the next thing we must look at. Take 30 seconds or so before we go into the other part. Or actually we look at what does healthy mean in reference to these stages of life. Into an hour and a half. And finally, the final thing. All right, let's go. Well, not the final thing. What does healthy mean in reference to this whole topic of life and a healthy life? Sano or healthy? Means what? Disfrutar de buena salud. Or specifically not enjoying good health, but also or more so cumplir to meet or perform las funciones corporales, to be able to perform basic body functions, jumping, walking, running, etc. with normalcy. Con normalidad We don't expect a baby to jump. So that is según la etapa, according to the stage in life, de vida. Yeah? So if you have a person that's not able to run a specific distance without great distress, then we're going to be not healthy. Somebody that is young and within a stage where they should be healthy, you know, then that's, that there's an issue there. Right? So we can sum up this by saying, una vida sana, a healthy life, is equal to, if you want to put it in like a sum, for instance, bienestar físico y mental. So a healthy life can be summed up as this, physical and mental well-being, in short. And that has to do with being able to carry out certain functions with a certain level of normalcy. Next, and finally, we're going to look at what are the pillars or the telltale signs of a healthy life. And we're going to look at, there are a couple of pillars. One is healthy food, physical activity. I'll put daily in brackets there. In some instances, it would be every day, about 3 times a week, that sort of stuff. Not falling to certain vices that threaten our health, smoking, excess drinking, that sort of stuff. And most importantly, one that is often overlooked, rest. This cancer and rest does not only have to deal with sleeping a certain number of hours per day, but it also has to do with being able to have downtime, free time. Yeah? Tiempo para ocio, time for leisure. So, to end off, let's look at the pillars of good health. Pilares, los pilares de buena salud. What are these pillars of good health? On one pillar we have la alimentación saludable. What does alimentación saludable mean? It means rejecting junk food and having a balanced diet. Rechazar. Now, junk food we would have learned is la comida basura. Another way of saying junk food is la comida chatarra. Rejecting junk food. This is a more upscale version of saying junk food once again. Rejecting junk food on one hand, and on the second hand, having or consuming una dieta balanceada, a balanced diet. Instead of balanceada, we could say equilibrada. So balance that. Another pillar of a healthy lifestyle is actividad física, taking part in physical activity. Actividad física. And how is that taken part? Remember, we saw before where lack of activity accounts for 6% of deaths, that is, of sicknesses that cause death, like diabetes and heart diseases or heart sicknesses. And we have where el, this is a long word, se den tarismo. Sedentaryism, if you want to call it that, or staying in one spot or not moving a lot. Being sedentary increases the risk of suffering from diseases. Aumenta el riesgo de, look at this word, suffers, sufrir, or we may also say padecer, that is a synonym for to suffer, de padecer de enfermedades.
Once again, physical activity or sedentarism, that increases the risk of suffering from sleeping diseases. So that's why we have to lead a healthy lifestyle. And one of the aspects of leading a healthy lifestyle is partaking in physical activity. Another pillar is, or pillar number three is, no incurring, not incurring or taking in, or taking part in los vicios, or certain vices. What are examples of vices? Fumar, no matter what it is, smoking and vaping is added to that list. Fumar, usar drogas, so cocaine, marijuana, etc. Or consumir alcohol. Consumir alcohol in exceso. Consuming alcohol in excess, using of drugs, smoking. All these are vices that deteriorate our health. And finally, finalmente, el último pilar, the last pillar is, ¿qué es el último pilar? The last pillar is descansar. Rest. And what is el descanso? What is rest? Or what is to rest? Sorry, what is descansar? Minimizar el estrés y tener tiempo para el ocio. So it is dormir, resting is sleeping, por lo menos, at least, 7 horas. This is for adults. Rest is also no, or not everybody, adult has stress, or minimizar, minimizing el estrés. And finally, tener tiempo, having time para el ocio, having time for leisure. So we have seen how stress helps us to relax ourselves. Sorry, not stress, but sport helps us to relax ourselves. And this is the final point when dealing with health and maintaining a healthy lifestyle. So that brings us to the end of class today, folks. As always, it was a pleasure having your company. And it's my pleasure giving you all this information. As I was saying to my students in school recently, it is so easy at this 99th hour to drop the ball and say, "Ooh, this has been a hard year. I've done so much work. I'm good. I do not need to go further. I don't need to push myself anymore. I am feeling as if I can't push myself anymore." But that's the wrong attitude to have. It's exactly at this time, the decisions that we make at this 99th hour, that will decide whether we have success or failure in our exams. So as we end up the class today, I just want to encourage you all to continue pushing, sticking to the studies, and do not drop the ball at this last minute, because it could mean the difference between a 1 and a 2. And it may seem very minuscule, it may seem very insignificant, but the worst thing is to get a 2 when you felt as if you gave your best 1, and it felt as if you knew all the information. So don't be discouraged. We move on tomorrow, same time from 10 o'clock. And we move on to module 2. And we'll take a rest. And you won't hear from me until next week, Monday. And I will post up, before this week is over, I'll post up a timetable on our schedule for classes during the course of next week and how we will tackle those classes. Once again, I just want to encourage everybody. Encourage your friends that are doing Spanish as well. Let them to go like Quintessential Language Learning. Most importantly, let them follow the YouTube page. We're trying to build our YouTube membership and engagement. And we need more persons to come on board. We need to let them know about Quintessential and the wonderful information you're getting here. Yeah? This is my passion, this Spanish is my passion, and this is my way of sharing with you. Of giving up that passion to your show teacher. So, everybody, have a wonderful and a blessed night. Make sure and rest up for the morning and take a read of the notes and the information we have received today before we start class tomorrow. Yeah? Take care.